Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 9 topics to cover, so let's get started. The Google Meetdown Add-ons SDK has graduated from the Developer Preview Program and is now generally available. This SDK lets you embed your app into Google Meet as an add-on where users can discover, share, and collaborate in the app without leaving Meet. The Add-ons SDK expands Meet's existing platform capabilities, providing the opportunity for developers to build interactive and collaborative experiences for your users in Google Meet, which they can find and install from the Google Workspace Marketplace. Check out the developer documentation linked in the description to get started with creating your own Google Meet add-ons. You can now make changes to your Google Workspace Marketplace app listing and save them as a draft. This lets you preview and test the changes before publishing them. While your changes are under review, the original app listing remains available on the Google Workspace Marketplace. You can update the configuration or details of your app listing in the Google Cloud Console and the Google Workspace Marketplace SDK. The Google Calendar API now allows you to programmatically create and manage birthdays through the new event type birthday. The Calendar API allows creating birthday events using the events.insert method. For existing event subscriptions you have created through the Google Workspace Events API, you can now change the event types you want to receive events for. In this example, using the event types field in the update mask parameter of the subscriptions.patch method, we are setting 2 event types that we want for our existing subscription. The Google Drive API returns a long-running operation every time you call the files.download method to download blob file content or export Google Workspace document content either through the Drive API or its client libraries. A long-running operation is an API method that takes a longer time to complete than is appropriate for an API response. Instead of having the user wait, it's better to return some type of promise to the user and allow them to check back later. When calling the files.download method, the response body consists of a resource representing a long-running operation. The method typically returns a link to download the file contents. The files.download method is the only way to download Google Vids files in MP4 format and is typically best suited for downloading most video files. Check out the comprehensive developer documentation to learn more about how to manage long-running operations. You can now use Looker in Connected Sheets from AppScript. Looker is an enterprise platform for BI, data applications, and embedded analytics that helps you explore and share insights in real time. The spreadsheet service has been updated so that you access and analyze Looker data directly within Sheets. You can now add a smart chip to your message that points to a chat space in any field that supports formatted text. This feature is available through the Chat Space Link Data object that has been added to the Rich Link Metadata field of the Spaces.messages resource. Google Workspace administrators can now call the Google Chat API to manage and search Google Chat spaces across their organization. This functionality lets them manage spaces at scale and automate common or repeatable tasks. If you're migrating to Google Chat from other messaging platforms, you can now create a group chat in import mode using the spaces.create method. This feature is available through the Developer Preview Program. Please hit that thumbs up button if you've liked this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in next month's news video.